Welcome to Beyond the Press channel.
Hello.
Today we are going to do lathe vs bicycle brake video again. And this time we are not going to use like small cross-country brake, but we have downhill brake. It's 4-caliber brake.
Brake for adults.
Yeah. And it's designed to take the heat that it makes when you go down the mountain. So maybe it can take the heat of the lathe little bit better. And with the downhill caliper, we are going to use cross-country disc, which is too small. So the disc shouldn't be able to take the heat, but this should. And I hope that we are going to get something like this, which was our car brake video, and not just red hot disc brake that we had last time on bicycle brake vs lathe video. And the setup is quite simple. The brake is there and the lathe is going to spin. I think I'm going to use quite fast speed. I think it was about same thing as you would ride 100 kilometers per hour with your bike, so pretty goddamn fast. And then when it's spinning, we have handlebars and brake lever. And I'm going to put like silicone glove on my hand, because if this explodes, then the hot brake fluid might be not very good. Yeah, and what is, Anni, your opinion? Is the disc going to explode?
No.
I say also that it's not going to explode. I think the car rotor was like much worse quality material than the brakes.
And now, please comment your opinion, what is going to happen.
Is it like this, or just this? Yeah, but let's put the cameras on and the lathe spinning. And here we go! Pretty hot! And the lever goes to the handlebar. It's boiling the liquid inside. It's too hot. But it's quite durable. It's still going on. Now this isn't doing anything anymore. I think the brake is dead. Ah, now it's... The handle feeling is really weird. I think we killed the brake. It isn't doing anything. Yeah, I'm going to stop this and let's have a look. Yep, and if you compare these to cross-country brakes, which had only 2-piston caliper and smaller like brake pads, I think more of the heat was now transferred to brake pads and less to the disc. I think the disc got even hotter and faster with cross-country brake than with this downhill brake. And the lever feeling was also different. With cross-country brake, it was only like 2 seconds and lever went all the way down. But for some reason, there was still a lot of brake pressure with the cross-country brake. I think maybe the brake fluid boiled so much that there was like steam inside of the brake line and that pushed the brake pads against the disc. But this time when the after like first maybe 10 seconds, the lever went to the handlebar, we lost all the pressure and it didn't break anymore after that. It could be that the brake fluids were boiling, but I also think that the brake pads just wore out so fast and then there wasn't enough material and the stroke of the pistons ran out and you couldn't brake anymore. And some of the differences between the two brakes could be also due to the brake pad like material. I have no idea what brake pads these were. I just took this from my downhill bike and I don't like keep books about what brake pads I use. I just buy something and they always work pretty well. Yep, so it has been now probably like 15 minutes and this is still pretty hot. And the brakes are now completely dead. And we destroyed these brakes because the levers are shit. They get stuck. So when they get hot, they get stuck. And there was recall on these, but these are so old brakes, I don't know, can I still get new ones? So I bought...
You can try now.
Yeah, but I already bought Shimano brakes. If I have to say some cool things about these, I think the sound of the lathe was completely different than on the last time. This had much more power than the cross-country brake. I think one bicycle brake isn't enough to explode the disc. I think if we would put like two brakes on one disc, it might work. Or then we should maybe use like motorcycle brake. That would be probably interesting. But the disc is in really bad shape if you look it from here. I think we are going to take this out and open this and have a look how warped this is. Yep, so if we look the disc first, you can see that it's not exactly like straight anymore. It's like almost maybe 10 millimeters, like in this cup-shaped form. And yeah, the lathe was here and the brake was here and for some reason move it on this direction, but it was probably pretty soft. And now when I look it, and I think if we are going to revisit this bicycle thing third time, then we are going to need new one of these. And then let's have a look on this. The lever side of the brake, this is still like completely cold, so it didn't damage this. And this looks to be okay. There is no leaks here or anywhere. So let's open it. I'm going to save these because these are really easy to lose and it's yeah, these are really easy to lose and now I have one extra one. So let's take the pin out. Usually these are really easy to take out. Yeah, here we go.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, so the problem is that these are completely gone. It was like steel against steel and they are not also, usually it's like just completely shiny and uniform, but now you have like big like dents here and here and here. This is a little bit better, but this is like, you don't want to see anything like this. And I think that because of the disc was so in so bad condition, it didn't work very well for these. And then the pistons, it's pretty hard to see those. But for some reason this isn't doing anything.
For some reason.
And even the spring that like pushes these out, this is also like bluish, so this has been stupidly hot. And I think also because this is much heavier piston than the cross-country one, there was too much of like mass to absorb the heat, because last time it got so hot that the brake line melted away. But I think this is also the installation of this brake line, which this is much better quality than on the cross-country brakes. I think they don't have anything like this so big. So, and downhill brakes are pretty expensive, so we're not going to test Shimano Saints or anything. Or if Shimano wants to send Saints brakes here, then we are going to give it a go, but I don't gonna buy more brakes. Yep, and my dad Timo stopped by on the workshop, and he had these new workshop caps. It says Konepaja Vuohensilta, which is our workshop. And Timo has also t-shirts. And I think if you would want some Konepaja Vuohensilta merch, I can throw them also to our store. So please leave a comment if you want.
Give all money for Timo.
Yeah, we can buy like gift to Timo with those money. Yeah, so if you want some Konepaja Vuohensilta merch, please let us know and I just put them to our store also. Yeah, but I think that is all for today.
Thanks for watching.
And have a nice day.
And for today's extra content, snow dump site and train is coming. And the snow dump site. And the snow dump site is famous because it was on newspapers on this week. And our neighbors hate it, and that's why it's
famous. But we like it because it's good content.
Good extra content all.
Yeah. But it sure looks like really ugly.